Escobar season has returned.
It's been a long time. Been a long time coming. It's life or death for me, man. But you know, there's no turning back now. This is what makes me. This is what I am, Bill.
Increasing questions about how close is too close between the two. Billions in government contracts are up for grabs, and with big tech companies fighting over these dollars, it leaves us to once again question the influence the government has over big tech, their censorship and surveillance of American citizens. When it comes to money, so, you know, money is, it controls right. A lot, and it's damaging.
And if they weren't engaging in this mass surveillance, they wouldn't need as much cloud storage, you know.
Damaging.
That alone should be a major flag. Like, what? Why do you need half of the state of Utah covered with these warehouses that you're stuffing people's data into?
So like I said, y'all, don't say that you can't get the truth from the news. Now, I don't know what news this is. I just happened to turn this on. Kim Iverson, this is my first time ever seeing this. I just seen this, you know, when it said NSA, I said, let me just check it out and see what they talking about with the big tech. But you hear what my man said, you know, if you want to go check this video out, you can, you know what I mean? But, you know, it was basically, like, you heard what my man said, man, you know, what the hell are they doing with all this damn data that they stealing from the people? These motherfuckers are stealing everybody's data on the damn planet, putting this shit into some fucking AI machine. Look, we all gonna die, man. We all gonna have clones down this bitch. From how I see it, they trying to trap us down here. That's how I see it. That's what this whole data fucking collection shit is all about. They trying to trap you into the simulation, dog. I guess if they figured, I don't know, maybe if they're... If they can steal or maybe harvest a clone of you or something, that should have just still keep you down here. I don't know, man. This some freaky ass shit. This some real freaky ass shit. This shit ain't for the weak, yo. You know what I mean? If you sleep, just stay asleep. Don't even fucking wake up. Just stay asleep, cause you ain't gonna be able to handle this shit.
Like, you would not believe it. I'm trying to get through the thick heads of Americans. Like I've been trying to tell y'all no. I'm trying to get through the thick heads of Americans. Like you would not believe it. I'm trying to get through the thick heads of Americans. Like I've been trying to tell y'all no over again. America don't love you. The people that are in power, they don't love you. America don't love Americans. Like I've been trying to tell y'all no over again. America don't love you. The people that are in power, they don't love you. They're all but telling you that if you get out of this country and you get your ass into a quagmire, we ain't coming to get you. If you get out of this country and you get your ass into a quagmire, we ain't coming. That if you get out of this country and you get your ass into a quagmire, we ain't coming to get you. Because if you can be there, and when we're there, and we can leave you behind in a third world country, to where there's a serious chance you're going to get murdered and killed. To where there's a serious chance you're going to get murdered and killed. What do? You just forget. This reminds me, but this is civilians. Soldiers are designed and they are trained to put up with inconvenience and the shit. But to be forsaken by this country that flies all these flags and stuff. Y'all understand what's going on? Civilian Americans by the hundreds, if not the thousands, has been forsaken by this country and the Joe Biden administration. We have left them behind and have slated them for death. I mean, the Taliban is already executing people over there that don't fit what they call their model citizen. But America has betrayed, the Joe Biden administration has betrayed Americans. They got some soldiers, they got the soldiers out. And they're showing this picture of the general, so-called being the last one there. Get it through your head. I'm trying to get it through your head, America. Get it through your head. Third world country, a warm, torn zone where these people are beheading their own citizens and stuff. You think they're going to have any love for Americans? And when it's all said and done, the spin is going to be, there ain't no Americans over there because they're all going to be dead. I mean, I can't get y'all to understand the gravity of this. I really, truly can't. But only way I can get you to understand this is if you was to put yourself in the shoes of the Americans that was told, don't come to the airport because we're under a hostile attack. Go over here. We may come and get you. We can't guarantee it, but go over there. And then the next thing you know, the last plane is out and you're forsaken America. I can only imagine if they ever make it back to America, and I'm not holding my breath. I can only imagine how bitter they would be. I mean, that would literally just make our own people become domestic terrorists when you find out that you got this, make our own people become bitter. They would be. I mean, that would literally just make our own people become domestic terrorists when you find out that you got this picture painted in your head of the way that America is supposed to be, and you got forsaken. Again, if you want to know the impact of this, put yourself in those hundreds of American shoes that is left over there in that worn, torn, third world country where we, in essence, retreated. We got our ass whooped. And we have let the whole world know, and all the Americans know, that the sacrifice and all the money, the time, the energy, the efforts, and the greatest arms deal that has ever been in America. We armed our enemy with over $85 billion of armament, the Taliban. Our enemy, we gave it to them. I mean, what was the problem with, first of all, getting all the Americans to a location first, getting them out of there, and then turn around and send some F-15s in there and just bomb the hell out of all the bases that we spent billions of dollars to build? But in essence, we have given them infrastructure. We have literally built them a country and a city in a sandbox. I'm serious. I wonder if they can even smell the shit anymore. I mean, man, I'm telling you. There's America that the people know, think like us. That this government is ran by people who think like us. It's not. It should be painfully obvious that it's not. It's not. It should be painfully obvious that it's not. There's America that the people know that exists. Then there's America that all the sellouts that are running this country that has existed. And they have all showed every single American that you will be betrayed. You will be forsaken. You will be left behind, and we don't give a damn about you. Forsaken. Every single American, that you will be betrayed. You will be forsaken. You will be left behind, and we don't give a damn about you. You will be forsaken. You will be left behind, and we don't give a damn about you. You'll be forsaken. You will be left behind, and we don't give a damn about you. You and they have all sold every single American, that you will be betrayed. You will be forsaken. You will be left behind, and we don't give a damn about you. And we all knew it was coming, but I am literally at a loss for words. I'm so glad I ain't doing a damn thing for this country. Hell no. I'm so glad I ain't doing a damn thing for this country. Hell no. Lost word. I'm so glad I ain't doing a damn thing for this country. Hell no. Not at all. Nothing.
Why? Because, nigga, the government is out here drilling niggas. And they playing games. There's propaganda campaigns taking place. There's billionaires after us. There's billionaires after us.
Incarcerated, you barely made it, how you escaped it? Contemplating, you realize what that time just wasted. Born in bondage, no in denial, you might as well face it. Mental change, you locked down on that wicked slave ship. Procrastination, you fucking around, that's masturbation. Those FEMA camps will send your ass on the long vacation. I'm sitting patient, I'm thinking hard in the basement basin. Whoever thought that my own government was really Jason? Who came to kill, steal, lie, cheat, I keep it real. You trust your God, I guess I'm wrong, cause I trust my steel. Intoxicated, you getting high, you medicated. Illusion state of mind, keep the world segregated. Inflammation that's in your joints is getting stiff. You so-called leaders got this world on the fiscal cliff. It's like the Titanic, this shit is going down. They took your constitution, ripped it up, it's on the ground. Life is getting hard, we talking kidney stones. We talking skull and bones, watch your back, they're making clones. Biological warfare, no fairy tale. You go outside and see the skies filled with chemtrails. What about the Pentagon? They didn't find a plane. You know their story's lame. Wicked devils run this game. This is the Great Depression or a great deception. My parents didn't warn me from my adolescence. Now I study the truth and hope to learn a lesson. Keep my head up, stay optimistic and count my blessings. Propaganda, they sell a nigga, but I'm not buying. Little kids dying, fuck the news, they all lying. Nigga, voters, motherfucker, DB, yeah, nigga.